Hello, I'm Olga, and I'm a director and co-owner of Definition Africa.
Hi, I'm Nadia. I'm a director and co-owner of Definition Africa.
I'm Nahida. I'm a director and co-owner of Definition Africa. The idea to start up Definition started in around 2009. We found that there was a gap in terms of being able to find products that are local in terms of their messaging. And so that's when we started to work on developing the concept, but it was launched in 2010.
I think that to begin with, there's a really big difference between a hobby and a business. So if you're gonna get into it and really wanna, you know, have this be your main source of income, you really have to put your all in, especially at the beginning. It might look, you know, only fun and, you know, creative and all that, but there's a lot of hard work that goes into it. And if you can stay, you know, on the road, it only gets better. Baby, can't
you see I'm trying? Definition is primarily a youth-driven brand. We've worked with a variety of different musicians, and we've tried to create a platform for different designers to take advantage of and to open up a space where they can collaborate with us so that they can see them out there and, you know, on the rack, and having the audience at large appreciate whatever it is that they brought to the table.
Definition employs approximately 20 people. There's the store, the shop itself, and then production. We have the printing section and the tailors and our admin and accounts.
One of our biggest challenges has been the fact that we built our business on the ethos that all of our products have to be African made, which means that we need to source all of the raw products, you know, from across the continent. That has been a challenge in terms of finding the right types of products, the right type of quality, consistency, all of those things. Aside from that, we started very small scale, so we don't have access to all of the machinery that we need. So our workshop is very manual. In a way, that has been great because it's allowed us a lot of flexibility in terms of working on a whole variety of designs, but it has definitely come with its challenges.
Our main customers are Ugandan. I'd say about 60% of them are Ugandan, which we're very excited about. We also sell a lot of our products to people in the expat community and tourists. And we've got a lot of inquiries online, international, like from people all over the world. And soon our website will be able, they'll be able to shop online.
Yes, you wouldn't put Senga needed or
danger material, but the idea works.
We are inspired by the things that are around us and the experiences that we live through every day. This is a beautiful city to live in, and it's colorful, and there's a lot to keep us inspired and keep us motivated. And that's true not only of Uganda, but of, you know, our neighboring countries and the entire continent at large, which is where we want to see our brand spread out into. So our inspiration really comes from living the African dream, I would say.